I've been thinking a lot about social media recently. And more importantly, what does the Lord God think of social media? So I decided I'm going to quit social media for 30 days. No YouTube, no Facebook, and no Instagram. Gone. The fact is this, guys. YouTube has changed so much from what it was 10 years ago. 10 years ago, when I'd just become a Christian, YouTube was a lifeline to me. There was Christian channels talking about things that no one else was talking about in church. There was Christian channels making videos on repentance, on holiness, asking big questions like, can you lose your salvation? And I really was blessed by these channels. And not only this, these channels, they used to get thousands, hundreds of thousands of views because YouTube was promoting these kinds of videos. But I do wonder if there's anyone else watching this now who's noticed what I've noticed. Every time I log in on YouTube, there seems to be something dramatic going on in the Christian community. Whether it's earlier this year, Lauren Daigle and her views on homosexuality. Whether it's Francis Chan and his associations with the New Apostolic Reformation. Joshua Harris and his recent divorce. Kanye West becoming a Christian. A street preacher having an argument, a massive baity argument in the streets. And all the time, there's all of these dramatic things going on YouTube. Now, please don't get me wrong, I'm not saying there's anything wrong with these videos, but is anyone else watching this now thinking, why so many though? What happened to the channels which used to just say, we're just preaching Jesus Christ and Him alone, the Bible is enough, and that's all we need to preach? But it seems every single YouTuber and his dog has jumped on this bandwagon. And YouTube has become this glorified gossip hub, a bit like a Hollywood magazine where we're talking about celebrities all the time, but we're forgetting to keep the main thing, and that's keeping Jesus at the center of our videos. And the vital truth is this, yeah, if you make videos about Christ alone, it's not going to pull in thousands of views on earth. But it will pull in thousands of views in heaven. I've never told anyone this before, but really, I started this YouTube channel out of fear. It was a couple of summers ago, and I was having real trouble with my legs. I was really struggling to walk. And I thought, if this continues in this way, there'll come a point where I can't go out street preaching anymore. There'll come a point where I can't get out of the house. So really, because I love preaching Christ and Him crucified, I wanted to have a platform where I could do it from that wasn't so reliant on getting out of the house. So I started off the Kirb Ministries. And it began to grow very slowly. But I noticed, the more that it grew, the more self-centered I became. The more Off the Kirb became bigger, the more I became envious and started comparing myself to other YouTubers, started comparing myself to others. And the more time I spent on social media, the more miserable I became. But then my wife gave birth to our son, our firstborn, Samuel Joseph. And the Lord hit me with a truth like a 400-pound gorilla. I realized this, that when everyone's done watching my videos, when there's no one watching them videos, I'll always have Emma and Samuel. So instead of staring at faces on Instagram, I decide to stare at one face, the face of my son. And I'll tell you what, it's the best face in the world to look at. Now, between you and me, in this fast over these 30 days, I'll let you into a secret. I didn't miss social media at all. I had more time to read, more time to study, more time with family, more time to think. And you know what? I even got to listen to some sermons from some local preachers in my town. I listened to audio sermons from them, and it really did bless me. And here's something else I learned. These preachers that are in my local town are no worse, if not they're better than the preachers that we're bombarded with all the time on social media, these big names. Actually, these preachers in my local town could preach a sermon just as good, if not better. And it's true, isn't it? Starbucks doesn't make the best coffee, does it? It's just the coffee which we're often bombarded with. So, here's the answer you've all been waiting for. Am I going to quit social media altogether? No. But I am going to make some big changes. Social media has been used by God greatly. Let's be honest now. Let's just be honest with one another. We've been able to get the Bible out into countries where there is massive persecution, into countries like Saudi Arabia, into Iran, into Iraq, into North Korea, and people have got saved through social media. And even on this YouTube channel alone, I've had people getting in touch with me saying, I'm going out open air preaching now because I saw one of your videos. I've made friends with people all around the world, people I would never have met if it weren't for this YouTube channel, and now I write emails to them every single week. And then there has actually even been people who have come to me and said, Joe, I became a Christian through this channel. So I'd be a fool if I pulled the plug on all of this, because the Lord has been blessing off the Kirb Ministries. But here are three changes which I've decided were very, very important for me to make going forward in the future. Number one, I'm unsubscribing to a ton of YouTube channels. When I go on YouTube, it's very cluttered, all of these different people all saying, watch my video, watch this video. And I have noticed something. As I've really been listening to some channels with big followings who might seem evangelical, who might seem really sound, when you do really listen to what they say, it can be a little bit scary to think, are they actually doing this for the Lord God? Or are they doing it for themselves? And some dodgy teachings can easily sweep into these big channels. So I'm just saying, just be very careful that they're not wolves in sheep's clothing. Be like the Bereans, even with my channel, go to the Word of God and say, is this man a liar? Is this man preaching the truth? Change number two. I've decided that every time I watch a video, every time I spend 10 minutes on social media, I need to ask myself this question. Are these 10 minutes worth sacrificing time with my family? Is this time I'm spending on social media worth sacrificing time with having fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ, with reading my Bible, with edifying my faith? And thirdly, my final change is this. I've decided that I'm not going to use my personal Facebook account as much anymore. I might post the odd Bible verse, I might post the odd picture from my ministry on Facebook, on Instagram as I feel led. But really, I want to encourage people to, if they want to get hold of me, don't send me a message on Instagram or Facebook. Please send me an email and I can get back to you in that way. Now, before we part ways, let me leave you with one final thought. I really do recommend to every single person, every single soul watching this video right now, I recommend that you go away and you do the 30-day challenge. No social media for 30 days. And I'll tell you, it'll give you some space to think. It'll put things into perspective and it'll give you time to just be still and know that He is God. And perhaps there's someone watching this now and maybe you're realizing that social media has been a huge distraction in your life and you might need to come off it completely. You might need to stop social media completely because it's distracting you from your intimacy with the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, if that's you, I welcome you to do that. If that means you're not going to watch my videos anymore, well, so be it. And any Christian YouTuber who's worth their salt will say the same thing. There is nothing more important than your fellowship with Jesus Christ. Jesus said, Martha, Martha, you are worried and careful about many different things, but only one thing is needful. And Mary has chosen that which is better. So every single one of you now, come off social media, come off YouTube right now, this second. Sit at the feet of Jesus, pull out your Bibles, and listen to what He's got to say to you right now.